Welcome all of you. We are going to discuss about something questions which is related with the value added tax. Most of the student sometimes they may not much convenience with the calculation of the VAT. On your study guides and whatever the discussions we already made, we can discuss about the theoretical part, right? Today we are supposed to discuss about something which is focused for some calculation point of view, right? Then value added tax is all of you well aware that if you basically if you concern about practical applications, it will little complicated, right? It will little complicated, but if you properly understand the theoretical part, right, then by doing some practice and understanding, you can get the conferred knowledge, then you can handle the questions which is related with your level, right? Mainly your exam paper is based on the MCQ, right? Then give the small scenarios, based on the scenarios, so then you have to provide the answer, right? Then there may be a calculation, sometimes there may be some theoretical part. On today discussions, we are trying to get idea by using the small scenarios, as well as we trying to prepare this entire questions by using this one. Then we try to get the understand how we prepare answer step by step basis. Sometimes you may think, right, why we prepare the entire question? Why once you prepare these questions, actually you can get the entire idea, comprehensive idea. With that understanding, right, easily you can provide the answer for your exam paper. That is our main focus today, right? We discuss one by one. While we are discussing, right, again we recall our memory regarding the calculation of value added tax, right? Right, there's a few questions. First one, which is related with the value of supply, right? Then value of supply. Then basically we can identify some main application here, right? First one is a considerations on money, right? Other one is a considerations not in money or partly in money, right? On consideration money, right? Then there is a value, right? Exact value you can identify, right? Then you can compare with considerations and open market value, right? Whichever is higher, right, should be taken as a value for the supply, right? If there's a considerations available on monetary value, right? Then other way, right? Other things, if consideration is not available, or it is available partly, right, we have to identify the value of supply based on the open market value. Open market value. What is mean of open market value? How it is identified, right? Then always for regarding the VAT, we should identify the VAT liability based on the open market value of the particular transaction, right? That is a compulsory requirement, right? How we identify the open market value? Then we have to compare with the other transaction, then we decide the open market value. To compare this one, we should identify the similar transaction which is taken place on similar situations, right? For that purpose, you have to concern about the item similarity and geographical similarities, right? Other responsibilities all should be similar, and this transaction should be taken place on the unrelated parties. If it is transaction taken place within the related parties, definitely this transaction may not be a fair market value, right? By comparing all these things, then we can identify the open market value, right? This open market value should be considered when deciding the value of supply. This is a normal application, but there is some sort of specific applications, right? Specific applications, right? Regarding some sort of specific industries like lottery industries, then land and improvements, right? Higher purchase industries, right? Likewise, some sort of specific identifications. For that purpose, then you have to identify it how it is decided, right? Then we take one by one and see how we decide the value for supply, right? First one, we consider about the lottery industry, how they decide the value of supply, right? Right, Mahidana Pahadili. අපි යම් ට්‍රාන්සැක්ෂන් එකක වටිනාකම මත තමයි ගෙවන්න ඕන වැඩබද තීරණය කරන්නේ රයිට් එහෙනම් වටිනාකම හැම වෙලාවෙම එකතු කළා ගෙවතු බදු සඳහා අපි තීරණය කරන්න ඕනේ ඒ වෙළඳපොළ වටිනාකම අනුව රයිට් ඕපන් මාකට් වැලියු එක අනුව එහෙනම් ඕපන් මාකට් වැලියු එක කොහොමද අපි තීරණය කරන්නේ ඒක තීරණය කරන්නේ ඒ හා සමාන ට්‍රාන්සැක්ෂන් එකක් या सामान प्रदेश सामान तात्याक सिधुन वना राइट ये सिधुम ये ट्रांसाक्षन दिपाश्वाद अनरिलेटेड पार्टी विन वना अन्नी वगे ट्रांसाक्षन वैल्यू तम अभी सलकांडी ओपन मार्केट वैल्यूल तीरनेकर राइट तरह अभी तीरनेकर संपूर्ण गणुन मुदाल मे वश पुलवा राइट गणुन कोटसा मुदाल मे विन पुलवा गणु संपूर्ण मुदाल नोवन तात्वाक රයිට් මුදල් මේ තත්ත්වයක් මත නම් මුදල් මේ වටිනාකම තියනවා වෙළඳපොළ වටිනාකමත් එක්ක සංසන්දනය කරලා වැඩියගේ වැඩබදු ගන්න කිරීම සඳහා පාවිච්චි කරන්න ඕනේ මුදල් මේ නොවන ආකාරයට වෙනවා නම් ගනුදෙනුව එහෙම නැත්නම් කොටසක් විතරක් මුදලින් වෙනවා නම් ඒ අවස්ථාවේදී වෙළඳපොළ වටිනාකම අනුව තීරණය කරලා ගන්න කිරීම කරන්න ඕනේ රයිට් හැබැයි ඊට අමතරව අපිට හඳුනා ගන්න පුළුවන් සම විශේෂ තත්ත්වයක් රයිට් ඒ විශේෂ තත්ත්වයන් තුලදී රයිට් ව්‍යාපාරික ස්වභාවය අනුව විශේෂත්වයන් අනුව අපිට හඳුනා ගන්න පුළුවන් වටිනාකම තීරණය කරන ක්‍රමය. රයිට් ප්‍රධාන වශයෙන් අපිට ගන්න හඳුනා ගන්න පුළුවන් ලොටරි බිස්නස් එකක් තියෙනකොට කොහොමද වටිනාකම තීරණය කරන්නේ. රයිට් හය පර්චස් ට්‍රාන්සැක්ෂන් එකේ කොහොමද වටිනාකම තීරණය කරන්නේ. ඊළඟව ගොඩනැගිලි විකිණීමක් කරනවා නම් කොහොමද වටිනාකම තීරණය කරන්නේ. රයිට් ඒ අවස්ථාව අනුකූල අපි මේ දේවල් හඳුනා ගැනීම කරන්න. අපි බලමු questions අරගෙන ඊට අදාළ ගන්නේ කිරීම එක කොහොමද මේ දේවල් තීරණය කරන්න කියලා. රයිට්. පළවෙනි එක question number 1 value of supply under the lottery. Right? That's a small question. Total collections from the Jayaviru lottery was rupees 100 million for the quarter ended December 31st. Price awarded during the period was rupees 30 million. Right? Then 1% commission paid to the agent on lottery distributors. Calculate the VAT liability, right? Then how we decided, right? Firstly, we should take the collections from lottery, right? How much? 100 million. 100 million. Okay. Right, out of this value we can deduct right cost for prices right how much 30 million right they can deduct it Okay. What else? They can deduct commission, agent commission. Agent commissions, right? 100 million into 1%, right? How much? 1 million. 1 million. Okay. What else? Further, they can deduct VAT for agent commission. VAT for agent commission, right? How we calculate? 1 million into 8%, right? How much? 80,000, right? After deducting those value, we can decide the value of supply. Value of supply, right? Right, this is the value we can take as a value of supply. Then we can apply the ratio, right? 8% we can apply, and finally we can decide the VAT liability. VAT liability, right? Likewise, there's a specific applications for calculation of the value of supply under the lottery business, right? Firstly, we can identify the total collections, right? Out of which we can deduct the cost of prizes, right? Then we can deduct the agent commission, right? Then we can deduct the VAT for the agent commissions, right? Thereafter, we can decide the value of supply. Based on the value of supply, we can apply the VAT ratio, right? Then we can decide the finally VAT liabilities, right? Likewise, then we can identify how it calculated, right? Then we apply the way of calculations, then finally we can get the answer, right? By the way, lottery business ke calculation ne ka abhyara collections value ka mata padanam vilam ne me ne de ganne kirim karan na itani adu karan pulwan ka mat tiyenawa e lottery ta adalawa prices sambandhin cost ek agent commission ne ak tiyenona eka adu karan puluwa agent commission ne VAT ek enona eka adu karan puluwa right e adu karayen passe ena value ek tamai ඒ ගණදුනේ වටිනාකම විදිහට වැඩ ගන්න එක ඉන්නේ සදා පාවිච්චි කරා. රයිට්? ඊට පස්සේ අනුපාතය ආදේශ කරලා අපිට පුළුවන් ඊට අදාළ ගෙවන්න ඕන වැට් එක හඳුනා ගැනීම කරන්න. රයිට්? මං හිතන්නේ පහදෙලි කොහොමද අපි ගන්න එක ඉදීම සිදු කරන්න කියලා. රයිට්? අපි ඊළඟට බලමු දෙවෙනි ක්වෙස්චන් එක. හයි පර්චේස් ට්‍රාන්සැක්ෂන් එක සම්බන්ධයි. Right, second one, value supply under the hire purchase agreement, right? Why it is so important or specific, right? If you compare with the hire purchase agreement with the leasing agreement, right, then leasing agreement, right, whenever installment due or installment collected, then it has created the VAT liability, right? But if you concern about the hire purchase at the very beginning, once they sign the agreement and pay the first rental, then there's a VAT liability at the very beginning for entire cash value, right? That's why on that point we have to identify this application, right? Right. Question number 2, finance company was facilitated to 1 million worth of brand new machineries on higher purchase term. Calculate the VAT liability, right? Then normally if you concern about the higher purchase, right, then there is the cash value, right? This is the value which is mentioned as a 1 million, right? Then there may be a finance cost, right? They will add some value, finance cost. Let's think and after they are taking some value, right? For our example, shall we take 300,000, right? Then 1.3 million, right? This value actually they are divided for the rentals and collecting from the hiring, right? For the VAT purpose, we only consider cash value at the very beginning, right? If there's a VAT liability at the very beginning, once they sign the agreement and the first rental, they have to pay the VAT for entire cash value, right? Then on this point of view, they have to apply 8% VAT applications, right? They have to pay 80,000 here as a VAT, right? This application, but there's a small thing you have to remember. For regarding the higher purchase, for brand new asset, you have to pay the VAT, right? Thereafter, second hand market, there's no VAT liability, right? If there's a transaction taken place after 1 year, right, from the first registration, then it is take as a second hand market, then those transactions take as a exempt supply, right? Therefore, most of the person with understanding this application, they are not take a higher purchase for the brand new machine or brand new vehicles, right? But there's a liability, you know, based on the cash value, they should pay the VAT component. They should pay the VAT component. මම හිතන්නේ අවබෝධය ලැබෙන්නේ නැති right higher purchase transaction වලදී විශේෂ තත්ත්වයක් තියෙනවා right higher purchase එක ගන්න අවස්ථාවේදීම ඒ higher purchase වටිනාකම සම්බන්ධයෙන් සම්පූර්ණ වටිනාකම පදනම් වෙලා වැටේ ගෙවන්න ඕනේ right cash price එක මත පදනම් වෙලා වැටේ ගෙවන්න ඕනේ හැබැයි අනිකුත් transaction අපි ගත්තොත් leasing වගේ දේවල් leasing එක installment එක due වෙනකොට හරි installment එක Let's see, given a good hurry, whichever is occur earlier, then they can consider for VAT liability, right? In sa, methana thina visheshathaya pahadili handunaganna higher purchase transaction ekak thiyenona brand new asset ekak sambandhayen agreement e sign karana welayama sampurna cash value ekata adalawa VAT ekaya gewanna one, VAT ekaya gewanna one, right? Right. Next one for related to the land and improvements, right? Land and improvements. Land and improvements, right? Then normally, right, transaction is taken place based on the value that should be calculated. But if there is a specific applications, right, then we have to consider for these deductions, right? Then firstly, we can consider with the sale proceed. Sale proceed, right? Out of this value. Firstly, we should remove the value of the land. Why we remove the value of the land? Lands are not liable for VAT. This is excluded items, right? Once we remove this one, then we can identify the some value. This is we can take as a value for improvements, right? Improvements, okay. Then out of this, right, we have to deduct, right, improvement cost as at 31st March 1998. Why? What is the reason? What is the reason? Actually, on this date onward, claiming requirement is provided to the taxpayer side, That means at the very beginning or the starting point of GST, Then onward, taxpayer can be claim the input tax, Thereafter, under the GST VAT, they can claim the input tax for purchases. But if you concern about the cost which is already incurred before that date, there is no any passivity like this. That is why here we are removing some value, Thereafter, we can identify the value flow supply, Here, this is the applications we have to consider, Question 3 and 4 mainly focus for this application, Shall we discuss question number 3, Then, land was purchased in 2012. For 2 million, improvement cost of the construction of the building was 500,000, During the period, but paid on improvement cost was rupees 20,000 and for advertisement of sale of the building was rupees 50,000. The market value of the land at the time of sale was rupees 4 million, Sale price of the land and building was 10 million, Based on this information, we should calculate the value for supply, Then land and building value, we can take as a 10 million here, 10 million here. Then out of this, we have to remove the land value at the time of sale, We can remove 4 million land value here, Then we can identify the value for improvements, 6 million, value for improvement, 6 million, Can we deduct cost of construction or improvement? It is not incurred before 31st March 1998, Though there is a specially mention about the cost, we can't deduct here. That is the reason this cost was not incurred before that date, 31st March 1998, Therefore, there is no any deductions here. This entire value we should take as a value flow supply. Based on this value, we can apply 8% to calculate the VAT payable. VAT payable, actually it is take as output tax. Then 6 million into 8%, we can take as a 480,000. Out of this, they can deduct the inputs, Input tax, they can deduct it, what are the input tax? VAT paid on improvement cost was rupees 20. Improvement is liable for VAT, no issue, they can deduct the VAT component here, right. Improvement, how much? 20 they can deduct it, right, 20 they can deduct it. Then second one, advertising for sale of building 50, can they deduct? They can deduct, but only part which is related with the taxable, right. Then for advertising, right, they can't deduct the entire value. What they have to do is, right, 50,000 related with the entire 10 million, right, but only liable 6 million, right. By apportioning, then we can decide the value they can deduct it, okay. Right, they can deduct 30 million here, so 30,000 here, right. Then finally, they can decide the 430,000 as a VAT payable. VAT payable, right. Likewise, they can identify the VAT payable here, right. Hari, edata balanda idam saha godnagili. Idamsa Vadidunu Kiri. Vikuna Namastavidi sale proceed decapitiranekara 10 million, right? Aking land deke value kadukara, land deke value kadukara, right? Land deke value adukarla, idabase, abihanduragata improvements alta dala value vik, right? A value vik in tamai, abida monohari kosteka tibbanang, idas namasi anu ate, tunai tisika isella, daran lada. වැඩිදුණු ක්‍රීමේ වියදමක් තිබ්බනම් අන්නේ වියදම අඩු කරන්න හැකියාව තියෙනවා. රයිට් එහෙම වියදමක් මෙතන නැහැ. ඒ දවස්වල ඉස්සෙල්ලා දරාපු වියදම. ඒ නිසා සම්පූර්ණ 6 මිලියන්ම වැඩේ සඳහා කන්සිඩර් කරන්න ඕනේ. රයිට්? ඒකෙන් අපි අවුට්පුට් ටැක්ස් එක හඳුනා ගන්නවා බදු අනුපාතය පාවිච්චි කරලා. රයිට්? ඒකෙන් යාට පුළුවන් ඉන්පුට් ටැක්ස් අඩු කරන්නේ. රයිට්? අඩු කරලා අවසාන තීරණය කරනවා වැට් එක ගෙවන්න ඕන ගාන කොච්චර වෙනවද කියලා. රයිට්? අපි මෙතනම බලමු ඊළඟ Question එක පාවිච්චි කරලා කොහොමද මේ cost එක තිබ්බොත් ගණනය කිරීම කරන්න. Right? 1998 331 එක ඉස්සෙල්ලා improvement එක සම්බන්ධයෙන් දරන cost එක තිබ්බනම් අපේ ගණනය කිරීම කොහොමද වෙන්නේ? Right? බලන්න ඊළඟ question එක question number 3 එකටම අදාළව තියෙන්නේ. Value supply under the lands and improvement. Land was purchased prior to 1st April 1998. The cost of the construction of the building as per the balance sheet date as at 31st March 1998 was rupees 1 million. Right? It was sold during this quarter for rupees 6 million. Market value of the land at the time of sale was 3 million. Calculate the VAT payable. Right? Right, sale proceed is 6 million, right? Here, sale proceed is 6 million, okay? Then, market value of the land at the time of sale, 3 million. Here, we remove 3 million. Why? Value for the land is not taken as a liable supply. It is excluded supply, right? After deducting this value, then 3 million we identified for value for the improvements, right. Out of this, right, 1998 March 31st as their financial statement, they identified there was a cost of 1 million was incurred, right? Right? Then that value we can deduct it. Then after that, we can identify the value liable for VAT component, value of supply, right? To decide the output tax, we can apply 8% ratio, 8% ratio, right? Likewise, then you can decide the value applicable for sale, right? Likewise, you can improve by getting or understanding about this few small questions, how we decide the value of supply. Mainly you have to concern main applications, right? Then money in cash, how we decide it. We have to compare open market value and we have to compare with the transaction value. Whichever is higher value, we can decide as a open market value, right? If value is not available, this transaction may not be happen or for market value, or partly it is in the market value, then directly we can take the open market value, right? In addition to that, right, then we decide value for lottery, right, value for the land and improvements, value for the higher purchase. Likewise, specific areas we can consider, right? Then sometimes you may think, right, where we have to decide the value, why we have to decide the value. If you remember, under section 2, right, whether we supply local market or domestic market, whether we import, then we should decide the value based on the value that should be calculated, right? For the importation, there is a separate application to decide the value. How we decide it, right? CIF plus 10% of CIF and other PAL, custom duty, right? Other taxes, all other things should be considered and apply the 8% ratio, right? For domestic market, right, then based on the open market value, we should decide it, right? Either normal way or either specific way, we should decide value of supply. This is the element of section 2, that is the important identification, right? Now we move into the question number 4, right? Question number 4, which is related with the time of supply, okay? Time of supply. Right. Firstly, recall our memory how we decide the time of supply, what is the importance? Time of supply. Why we have to identify the time of supply? As appeyo velawa kiyana eka wedagath wenne. Right? If any transaction, if completed within shorter time, it is not much more importance. Right? Why? Within the 1 day, 2 day, they can decide it, right? But some transaction not like this. It may be taking more than 1 year, 2 years time. On that point of view, right, then exactly they should decide the time at which this value of the transaction should be considered for the VAT calculation purpose. Right? Certain things may be happen. Sometimes they are collecting the advance, sometimes they receive the payment or receivable as the agreement, right? Sometimes they deliver the goods or they provide the service, later they issue the invoice. Normally, as a commercial terms, right, once issue the invoice, it is recognized for the revenue purpose. That's the normal applications, right? But for the VAT purpose, right, until issue the invoice, we need not to wait, right? Before that also, we have to consider, we have to identify the value for the VAT, right? That is the purpose here. right. Then these applications mainly consider supply of goods, right. Then we consider supply of services, then consider about hire purchase, right. Then consider about the other transaction, other agreement, right. Then again we consider about the payment basis. Right, already we discussed about the theoretical part, right. Just I recall your memory and just we discuss the question, right. Then how we decide time of supply at the point of supply of goods, how we decide it, whichever is occur earlier, what are the things we should concern. First one, payment received for goods already delivered or future transaction, payment received. Then second one, payment to be received, right, payment to be received, their agreement or whatever thing, there's a requirement or eligibilities. Sometimes it may not be received yet, right, but there's based on this agreement it can be identified, it should be identified, right. Then next one is good delivered or invoice issued. Out of four, whichever is occur earlier, then we should decide the time of supply, right. We should decide the time of supply, okay, right. Second one, supply of services, how we decide it, advance received, payment to be received or whether received or not, right, service performed, invoice issued, right. Out of four situation, whichever is occur earlier, then we should decide the time of supply. For both situations, right, supply of good or supply of service, they has a proviso. If they perform the service, if they deliver the goods within 10 days, if they issue the invoice, they can ignore the date of delivery of the goods. They can ignore the date of performing the service, right. Then depend on the invoice date, they can consider for what liability, right. Likewise, based on the given specific rules, then we can decide the time of supply. That is important. Why? Based on the time of supply, then decide at which point this person should be collect the VAT and pay the VAT to the department, right. Then what is application for the hire purchase? What is application for hire purchase? Hire purchase transaction, what I mentioned earlier, right? Hire purchase transaction is consider at the time of sign the agreement and make the first rental. And that point actually it has incurred the time of supply for the VAT purpose. Right, on that basis we can identify the time of supply. But if you concern about other agreement like leasing or whatever other agreement, whether rental is due or whether rental is received, whichever is occur earlier, then we should decide the time of supply, right. Last one is important, there is a specific applications, but normally VAT is based on the accrued basis, right, whether cash received or not, right. If transaction taken place, then they should identify it for VAT, output tax. Same as, right, whether payment is made or not, right, if expenses incurred which is under the VAT payment, right, then taxpayer can be claimed the input tax, right. Normally it is depend on the accrued basis, right. But if any person, if especially take the approval from the CG, they can apply the payment basis, right. Sometimes there may be a practical scenario, right, based on the 1 and 2, right? If they are, let's think, if they are provide the service, right, and issue the invoice, definitely they should consider for VAT purpose. But actually, they are providing 1 year credit period for this supply, right? After 1 year, they receive the income, but depend on the service performed, depend on the invoice issued, they should identify the VAT. They should identify the VAT. Okay. On that basis, most of the person, they may not possible to run the business, right? Run the business, but actually, they had to do. They can get the approval from the CAG to adopt for the payment basis. To adopt for the payment basis, right? If they get the approval, if they get the approval, right? Whenever cash received only, they should take under the output tax. But other way, there is a limitation as well, right? They can't deduct the input tax without payment made, right? Same input tax also they should consider once they make the payment, right? Once they make the payment. Likewise, they can identify the time of supply. Right, this is the applications, right? Based on this understanding, right, based on the recall or regarding the time of supply, then we can complete the question number 4. Okay. Question number 4, based on the following details provided, determine the time of supply for the service provided by the registered person and balance tax liability of the transaction. Okay. Then first one, rupees 1.5 worth of advance received on March 20th for regarding the future performance of the agreed services, right? Then first one on March 20th, right? Advance received, okay? How much? 1.5 million, rupees 1.5 million, okay? Right. Then second one, according to the terms of the agreement of the both parties, sum of rupees 1.5 million have to be received on 10th May. May 10th. Amount to be received. Right. How much? Rupees 1.5 million, right? Then agreed service was provided on December 25th. Services performed. Right. Then sum of rupees 6.5 worth of invoice issued on January 3rd. Invoice issued rupees 6.5 million. Right. This is the transactions we can identify. Simply, if you concern about the quarter, this is related with the quarter one on first year, year 1, right? This is for quarter 2 of the first year, right? This is for quarter 4 of the first year, right? Then second one, quarter one of the second year, right? Right, there's 2 years, no? First year and second year, right? You can add 2018 or 90, whatever, you can take it, right? If you are separately taken, right, this transaction may be completed after, nearly after 1.5 years time, right? Normally, if they wait to identify the VAT, up to what extent they have to wait? They have to wait until issue the invoices, right? They start at the very beginning of the first year, right? More than 1 year time they had to wait to identify the VAT and identify the revenue for the account purpose, normal application. But based on the time of supply, right, due to having the time of supply, right, whichever is occur earlier, we should decide the time of supply, right? Then first one, then 20th March, advance received. At that point, then there was a point we can identify, right, occur earlier, right? Depend on that, right, on first quarter of the first year, they should pay the VAT only for 1.5, just apply the 8%, 120 they should pay. Sorry, 140. They should pay, okay? Right. Then second one, 10th May. They should be received the payment as the agreement. Whether received or not, depend on the agreement. If they had received, then they should identify the VAT accrued basis. Right, on accrued basis, right, for 1.5 million into 8%, then another 120,000 they should consider for VAT calculation, right, they should consider for VAT calculation on second quarter of the first year, right. Then third one, they perform the service on 25th December, right, then it was taken place on fourth quarter of the first year, right? But simply you have to compare number of days here, right? If they perform the service within 10 days, if they issue the invoice, right? If they issue the invoice, they can ignore the date of perform the service. Directly they can take the date of invoice issued, right? Just we can take nearly 9 days here, right? Therefore, we can ignore date of service perform, right? Then we can identify the VAT based on the date of invoice issued, right? How we calculated for 6.5 million into 8%. Right, 520. Out of this, we can deduct VAT already paid. How much? 240. No, 240. Then VAT payable, we can decide it. $280, right? Likewise, then we can decide the VAT chargeability, right? Thrapi, yano tirne karana pulwa quarters tike kochchara pramanayak, right? Given on the a quarters anu तर टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई का अनुतम तीरने करान एम नतुना ना ट्रांसैक्शन संपूर्ण विवरण का वेट गिवन आवश्यकता व्यक्त नहीं इनवॉइस इश्यू करने का वेट गिवन नोड ने है भाई टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई के पहली लिवा की नोआ विच एव इज ओकर लिए वी शुड पे द टैक्सेस राइट तर एडवांस से लाभ चिला ये गांठ वेट गे हुआ राइट अमाउंट टू बी रिसीव्ड अंदुना कत्तना वेट गे हुआ राइट इट वाज मेड ए कंपेयर करला विच एव इज ओकर लिए राइट विद इन 10 डेज निसा अभी इनवॉइस डेट का तीरने करा राइट लेट्स थिंक राइट इफ एनी पर्सन just think about the tax planning they arrange like this why if they consider right if they issue invoice after 10 days what would be the matter right let's think they are issuing invoice on 6th January right after 10 days based on the service performed they should pay the VAT same value they should pay the VAT on 4th quarter of the first year they can't wait until 1st quarter of the second year right that is a thing we should consider right okay we consider about the time of supply as well right
right
now we are concerned about the how we claim the input tax right when we claim the input tax several things we should consider under section 22 many requirements you have to comply right then mainly input tax which is directly connected with the taxable activity only we can claim right if it is not connected with the taxable activity there is no possibility to claim the input tax that is the main important point right in addition to that they should collect tax invoice for local purchases or custom good declarations for the imports right then if there is any excluded supply or exempt supply right whatever the input which is related with that part should not be allowed to deduct it right if whatever the taxable invoice or custom good declarations they should claim within the prescribed period right within the prescribed period right those are the things actually they should concern mainly in addition to that whatever the input which is related with the consumption right like traveling some input which is related with consumption of the stop right those are not allowed to deduct it right likewise some certain limitation you have to consider right by using this question we try to get understand how it is impact to the VAT calculation right question number 5 partnership has taxable supply and exempt supply value of such supply is rupees 43,600,000 and 14,800,000 respectively. Then input VAT paid on overhead expenses 2,450,000. Calculate the VAT input credit claim. Right here to supply taxable supply. Right. Exempted supply, right? Taxable supply is how much, right? 43,600,000, right? Exempt supply is 40,800,000, right? If you take the total supply. $68,400, right? Then here we identify the common inputs for the common expenses. how much? 2 million, right? 2,450,000. 2,450,000, right? Out of this, right, whichever the input which is related with the taxable supply, they can claim it, right? But the if input which is related with the exempt supply is not allowed to deduct it, right? That is a simple application here, okay? Right? How we separated? How we separated? On this case, right? If there is any direct identifications, there is no issue, right? Without complexity, right? Directly they can identify it, and whatever the input which is related with the taxable supply, they can claim, right? Whatever the input which is related non-taxable activities, there is no possibility to claim. What is mean direct identification? Sometimes let's think, right? Then both supply in within the one company, right? But there is a two different division. Separately they purchase the materials, whatever the service they separately taken and do the separate production process. Then without any harm they can identify input which is related with the taxable supply, input which is related with the exempt supply or non-taxable supply, right? No need to have ratio or no need to proportion based on turnover, directly they can identify, right? If there is a proper way, then no issue, right? If you are, you can prove that, right? If taxpayer can prove that, then department will accept, okay? But there is some sort of common expenses, right? Let's think, right? Even within the one entity, there is a two different separate divisions for taxable and non-taxable. There is some sort of common expenses like security charges, janitorial charges, some internet like main thing, some common one. Those common one we should separate it. How we separate it? Based on some proper mechanisms. For that purpose, normally, generally, we are using the turnover basis. Depend on the turnover, then we can decide the calculations. Depend on the turnover. Okay? Right. Then on this case also, right, it is related to the common expenses. How we decide? How we decide the input which is related with the taxable supply? Taxable supply. Okay? Right. How we take that? 2,450,000 into 68,400,000 divide and into 43,600,000. Right? Then we can identify the value here. Right? Right, then we can identify 1,500,000, right, 61,695,000. Right, this is the value we can identify for taxable supply, right? In wording we can see, right, input tax for common expenses, right, dividing total supply into taxable supply. By using this formula, we can identify it, right, input which is related with the taxable supply, right? Only that portions we can claim, right? Only that portions we can claim. Here value is 1, okay? Right. Then shall we do the next one? Right. Question number 6. Question number 6. K10 Enterprise has made the export amounting to ₹95,450,000. In respect of such export, ₹12,100,000 has been paid as a VAT on purchase of material and accessories, right? Okay. The value of local supply made is ₹16,800,000, and all the other imports VAT paid on both supply amount into ₹3,567,000, right? Then calculate the input VAT credit claimable, right? Then there is a exports supply and there is a local supply, right? Then VAT on purchase of raw material and accessories, right, is right, in respect of the export, right, then 12,100,000, which is identified as a VAT on purchase of the raw material for export, right. Then value of local supply is also there, ₹16,800,000. Then for both common expenses, right, they identified input VAT payment as a ₹3,567,000, right. Then pahadili me ayatane export tiyenawa local supply ekak tiyenawa export material sambandhayen wenama adunagena tiyenawa direct input tax ekak. Right, ekaṭa proportionate karanna avashyathawayak naha ne, direct identification ekak thiyenawa. Direct identification ekaṭa anuwa handura ganna puluwan kochchara pramanayak ekaṭa adala wenawa, directly ma adala wenawa. Right, hawai issue ekak thiyenne ara man kiyuwa wagema common expenses sambandhi. Kohomada common expenses walata adalawa input ekak handura ganeema karanne. Right. Right, here export supply, how much? 95,450,000, right. Then local supply, 16 million. Right, 112,250,000 we can as a total supply. Right, total supply. Right, then if you concern about the export, right, then they can claim the input tax without considering the 100% of the output tax, right. Whatever the input related, entire value they can claim, right. Therefore, separately we should identify the input tax for export, that is a concern, right. On that basis, right, we decide the total supply. And we identified input tax for export supply, okay. Then direct identifications, directly identified. How much? 12,100,000. It was directly identified, right? Then second one, from common expenses, right? How we decided? 3,567,000, right, into total sup, into export supply 95,450,000, divide on total supply 112,250,000, okay. Right, here they can claim 3,033,142, right. By applying this common proportionate basis, right, they can identify input tax which is related with the common expenses that will be related to the export, right. Then you can take the total amount, right, this total amount we can call as a input tax for export supply, or you can say zero rate supply. Right, 15,133,142, right, this is the amount they can claim, right. But normally, normal applications, right, what we have to do is we can't claim the input tax more than the 100% of the output tax. Those limitation is not relevant for zero rate supply, SVAT and 227, right. Therefore, that by applying this, then you can decide separately input tax which is related with the export. මයිදන් පැහැදිලි export වලට අදාළව සාමාන්‍යයෙන් ගන්නේ කිරීමේදී තියෙන limitation එක අදාළ වෙන්නේ සාමාන්‍ය ගන්නේ කිරීමේදී limitation එක තමයි available input tax එක අපි compare කරන්න ඕනේ 100% of output tax එකත් එක්ක whichever is lower තමයි අපිට ගන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නේ deductible input tax එක විදිහට හැබැයි input tax export එකට අදාළ input tax එකක් තියෙනවා නම් එම limitation එකක් නැතුව අපිට claim කරන්න පුළුවන් right අපිට claim කරන්න පුළුවන් right ඒ අනුව තීරණය කරන්න ඕනේ කොච්චර ප්‍රමාණයක් යාර claim කරන්න පුළුවන්ද export එකට අදාළව right okay shall we move into the question number 7 right Jayo Garment has suspended supply and export Value of both supply is rupees 18,267,000 and 54,360,000 respectively. Total input VAT paid is rupees 8,250,000. Out of such VAT, 140,000 is relating to the benefit provided to the employee, which was not taken. For output tax, computer VAT input credit claimable, right? right. Export supply and SWAT supply, right. This SWAT supply, other way we can call as suspended supply. Suspended supply, right. Then suspended supply is 18,267,000. Right, then export supply 54,360,000. Right, both is eligible to claim input tax, can claim more than 100%, more than 100%, right. This is application here. But on this case, they incurred input tax is 8,250,000 here, right. This is the value. On this value included 140,000, which is related with the benefit provided to the employees. Those are not included under the output tax, right. Then here we should take as a disallowable. Disallowable input tax, right. That is related with benefit of employees, okay. Then they can deduct 140,000. Those is not eligible to claim the input tax. $8,110,000, right. Entire this value without any issue, right, they can claim the input tax. 0% and SWAT 227 are same application here. Same application here. Without 100% limitations, they can claim the input tax. Right. Tara yanuwa pahadili export natang 0% supply sadaha SWAT sadaha adala wada input tax ekak sampurnen adu karanna puluwankama thiyena. Right. Apita proportionate kala ganna awashyathawayak naha me dekama thiyena ekak category eke. Right, with the liable supply එකක් තිබ්බනම් මේකත් එක්ක අන්න අපිට compare කරන්න අවශ්‍යයි. අපිට බලන්න ඕනේ වෙන් කළ හඳුනගෙන ඇත්තම මේ 100% limitation එක ඇතුළේ වැටෙනවද මේ කොටස. Right, by 0% එකයි SWAT එකයි දෙකම එයාට 100% input tax claim කරන්න more than 100% claim කරන්න පුළුවන් directly ඒකටම අදාළව input tax එක තියෙනවනේ. දැන් මේක මේ ප්‍රධාන වශයෙන් supply dekai tiyenne suspended supply export ekak dekama ekak category ekak tiyenne right limitation ekak na sampurna input ekak adu karanna puluwa habai ekama deyak tiyenne api disallowable input tax ekak consider kala ek ayin karanna ona ayin kala thamai allowable input tax ekak thamai claim karanna puluwang wenna right right few basic calculation we consider right small calculations. Now we are going to discuss about the overall calculations by using a small question, not much complex questions, right. Step by step basis we trying to calculate. Sometimes examiner may focus for any steps. Sometimes they partly prepared and balance part you have to prepare and provide the answer, right. Sometimes give the one question based on this one questions. They may focus for few MCQ, right, based on the one scenario. Likewise, examiner may develop the question, right. Like therefore, we have to have good understand regarding the overall calculations, right. Not only that, we should have the idea and understand how we do the small point of calculations, then easily you can manage the application behind, right. Right. Question number 8, according to the following particulars relating to the Excel Limited, VAT registered company for quarter ending 31st March, shall we take as 31st March 2020, right? Then figures given below excluding the VAT, right? Those information is related with the 3 months, January, February and March, there was a sales value, import cost and local purchases, right? Then at the end they are providing the additional informations, brought forward input tax, disallowable input tax and installment paid, right. Based on this we should decide the VAT calculations, right. Okay. Here we are going to calculate for Excel Limited. Excel Limited, right. Then quarter ended 31st March, okay. Calculation of VAT payable. Right. Then we take output tax, okay. Then we have to take the value, then rate equal tax, okay. Right. Then first one we take liable supply, right. The note number 1 we can consider, right. Here note 1 output tax, right. Then for January, for February, for March. Right. For January, sales value is 3 million, 3 million here, right. For February, sales value is 1.9, right. For March, sales value is 3.2, total supply we can consider, right. Here we should take the pick like this, liable supply, okay. Then this value we can use here, 8.1 million into 8% ratio, right. Then we can identify the VAT output tax. $648,000 is the only supply available, right. $648,000 we can take to the final column, right. Then we have to decide the input tax. Credit, okay. Then first one from importation, importation. Second one from local purchasers, right. We take note number 2, note number 3, okay. Then note number 2, input tax from importation, right. January, then February and March, right. For January, they imported 1 million worth of material here, 1 million worth of material. For February, they imported 1.5 here, right. For March, they imported 300,000, right, altogether 2.8 million. Then we apply 8% ratio here. Okay, right. This value we can take it here, 224,000 as a input tax from importations, right. Then we see about the note number 3. Right. Note 3, input tax from local purchasers, okay. Then January, other expenses 700,000. February, 1.5 purchases, other expenses 600, altogether 2.1 here, right. Then third one, March, purchases 1.2, other expenses 400, 1.6 here. $4.4 million, then we can apply 8% ratio, right. $352,000, right. Here we can take the value $352,000, right. Then we can take the total, right. By using the two notes, then we can identify input tax for importation and input tax for the local purchases. Right, then we can take the total here. $576,000 total. This is the value we can call as allowable input tax for the period. Sorry, it should be a input tax for the period, okay. for the period, right? Out of this, then we can deduct this allowable one. I think you remember the steps, right? Disallowable input tax, okay. Here there's a additional information provided, right? 40,000 we should disallow. We should disallow. 536,000 we can identify here. That amount actually we can call as a allowable input tax for the period, right? For the period, okay, right? Then we can complete some extent, right? Then after identify the allowable input tax for the period, whatever the brought forward from previous quarter, we should identify it, we should add it and identify the total input tax. Therefore, here we should add, right, brought forward input tax from previous quarter, right? How much? As a given information, 125,000 here. Then we can identify it, total input tax. Total input tax. $661,000 we can identify as a total input tax. Can we deduct this directly? No, directly we can't identify, no, right? Firstly, we have to identify the deductible one, right? After identify the deductible one, then we can decide it up to what extent we can deduct from the output tax, right? Then what we have to do is we have to identify the deductible input tax here. Deductible input tax, right? On this calculation, right, there's a two part, part A and part B, but on this case part A is not relevant, right? Part A is related with input tax for zero rate of supply, SVAT 22.7, right? On this case, there is no any applicability, right? No any value here, okay? No any value here. Second one is a balance part, right? Balance part. For that purpose, what we have to do is, we have to identify the two items. One is 100% of output tax, right? 100% of output tax. We have to compare with balance input tax, balance input tax, right? Then 100% of output tax, it clear, right? We already calculated 648,000 into 100, into 100, right? Here value would be a 648,000. Okay, balance input tax, why we take the balance, right? If it is apply the A, right, there would be a value here. If so, then total amount we can't consider as a available one, right? then on this case, right, 661,000 is take as a total input. Out of this, if any value taken here, we should consider, but on this case 0, right, no any value deduct, value relevant for under item number A, right. Therefore, available balance we can take as 661,000. You have to compare these two and get the lower value here, right, here 648,000, okay. Then you have to take the total sum value of A and B, right, here 648,000, that mean A plus B, okay. Right, then after deducting this value, right, if there is any remaining value, we can take as carry forward input tax, right. Right, here remaining value is 13,000. This 13,000 can be take as a carry forward input tax, okay. What is mean carry forward input tax? As a normal rule, we can deduct up to the 100% of the output tax, right. If any value more than that, right, we as a normal rule, it is not eligible to deduct the under the output tax, right. Whatever the excess amount, only options we have, we can carry forward to the next period, right. This same type of applications we can consider here, no, right. On previous period, right, after calculating this type of way, they identified 125,000 is remain, right, without deducting out of the output tax, right. Only options they do, they bring into the this particular quarter. Same here also, right. This 13,000 they can forward to the next period, next quarter, then they can consider it can be included on the total input tax, right. To decide the VAT liability, what we can do is here we can take the deductible input tax for the final case, 648,000, and deduct the value here. Then thereafter we can decide the VAT payable, same output tax and same input tax claim, no any VAT payable here, right. In addition to that, on this question is already paid installment payment, right. Here we can deduct installment payment paid 30,000, right. Then there's no liability mean, ultimately they can take the refund here, right, refund you, okay. This is a total calculations with regard to the VAT payable, right. But only thing is that you have to identify step by step basis, right. If you are not identified step by step basis, sometimes you can do that, but sometimes calculations may not be correctly reflect for the final answer. But when you are doing the MCQ questions, it does not mean you need to prepare the entire things. Sometimes examiner just prepare and see, provide it right, output tax is this much, deductible total input is this much, you have to decide the deductible input tax and you have to decide the VAT payable, right. Likewise, some sort of steps examiner may already calculated and provide to you, right? Depend on the balance part, then you have to calculate the value based on the available information, right? Then finally, it can be decide the required answer on your MCQ questions. That is a requirement for the your exam point of view. But to decide the answer, right, there should be a proper understanding, right? Just you run through with the theoretical part, right, and you try to identify way of here and there, right? It may sometimes you can do that, but most of the time you may not possible to complete the correct and complete answer. That's why firstly take the comprehensive questions and improve your knowledge, right, practice with that, then thereafter you can do the whatever the required steps based on the examiner given information. Right, අපි බලමු මේක calculation එකම දැන් ඔයාලා මේ preparations එකේදී right output tax එක හදනකොට right දැන් අපි මෙතනදී තිබ්බේ liable supply එක විතරයි right මීට අමතර supply තියෙන්න පුළුවන් right export supply එක suspended supply SWAT supply වගේ දේවල් exchange supply තියෙන්න පුළුවන් right ඒ දේවල් එක calculation එක අපි ඉස්සරහදී राइट मेथन दी करे सामान्य लाइबल सप्लाई का दिन गाता लाइबल सप्लाई वैटे का पावचिक युदागत्ता राइट वैटे कैलकुलेट कर रेट का पावचिक अवसर तीरने करा आउटपुट टैक्स विनोद राइट तो आप हमें कैलकुलेशन स्टेप बाय स्टेप करें समहार दर उत्साह कर स्टेप बाय स्टेप करने काट पाड़ कर राइट तर मैं गाना काटपाड़ा कल हरियाणा नहीं राइट गाने स्टेप ऐ मेक प्रिपेयर कराने की बेदगत एक हाँ गाने का बेदगत राइट तर मिथन दी बलू इंपोर्ट टैक्स राइट इंपोर्ट सोलिंगा इंपोर्ट टैक्स तीन एक हाँ गाँव टाइम लोकल पर्चेस कर पड़ी हाँ राइट क्वार्ट इकट मदाल कैलकुलेशन करा मस तुम एकतु इकट एक कैलकुलेशन कर देखेम काल सीमाट अदाल इंपोर्ट टैक्स काल सीमाट अदाल इंपोर्ट टैक्स अदास्करा मे सीरम देवल अडुकरा पुलवां राइट एक अडुकरा बेरी मुन देव डिसलाबल देवल तीन अयंकरा डिसलाबल अभी देना 40,000 अभी यदि अयंकरा पास अभी हंधुन का अलाबल इंपोर्ट टैक्स ना मे देवल अडुकरा पुलवां अलाबल इंपोर्ट टैक्स राइट मैं अलाबल इंपोर्ट टैक्स की अदास्करा अलाबल उना के एक मे काल सीमा अड़करा पुलवां राइट एक इसल काल सीमा अड़करा बरीवेला इसरा गेर देवा एक पुलवा राइट ये दिवाला एक ब्रॉड फॉरवर्ड इंपोर्ट टैक्स ना ब्रॉड फॉरवर्ड एक ना टोटल प्रमाण अपने हंधुन का पुलवा राइट टोटल प्रमाण अपने हंधुन का हंधुन के एक तम गाने की करोने क्वेश्चन प्रमाण मे आट अड़करा पुलवा राइट अड़कर प्रमाण तीरने के रि अभी बलोने मे अदाल टैक्स पेयर एक क्वार्ट तुला क्वेश्चन प्रमाण क्वेश्चन प्रमाण इंपोर्ट टैक्स तीन अद सह इंपोर्ट टैक्स अदाल सप्लाई पुनः तीन मे गाने मेदन एक्सपोर्ट ने सीरो सप्लाई ने SWAT bug ne right 227 kiyanne wenama application ekak right apma eka pahadili karanna right ether me dekama ne enam a kiyana category ekata adalawa mukut input ekak ganna ba haba a kiyana category ekene ganna walan eyara limitation ekak ne whatever the import which is related with export and SWAT they can claim but on this case no any supply available here under the zero rated and SWAT, therefore they are not eligible to claim any value under the zero rated and SWAT, right? Then we compare 100% of output tax. Here the CIA input the output take. Api output take calculate kali varai. Na output take here CIA gatta balance input take gatta. Samahara daruvan prasthe thre. I mean balance input take ganne kela. balance input එක ගන්න හේතුව තමයි අපි දැන් මේ මේ ගානේ ගැටලුවක් නැහැ right මෙතන value එක බිඳුවයි අපි example එකක් විදිහට හිතමු මෙතනට ආව 61000 calculate කරන් පස්සේ දැන් අපිට කෙලින්ම ගන්න පුළුවන් මේ ගානම නැහැ දැනට අපි 61000 එක use කරලා ඉවරයි item 1 එකේදී right use කරලා ඉවරයි item 1 එකේදී okay रिमेनिंग पार्ट का अभी गो कंसीडर करें रिमेनिंग पार्ट का अपने कंपेयर करें 100% निक राइट कंपेयर कर अभी तीरने विच बेस लो लो वैल्यू तीरने के अगे तीरने मेतन लो वैल्यू तीरने के रही अवेलेबल इनपुट वैडी राइट 100% ऑफ आउटपुट टैक्स एनी शातम अवसाने 13000 अड़क रहा बेर इसरा गिनी वे राइट अड़क रहा बेरव इसरा गिनी वे राइट एन आप तीरने करा डिडक्टिबल वैल्यू एक राइट मिथन जीरो वैल्यू एक अर्थम आवे नहीं आउटपुट सामान इनपुट टिकट आउटपुट सामान इनपुट टिकट ऐ सर अवसाने वेट पेबल जीरो वेट पेबल जीरो अब मेवेन मैं इंस्टॉलमेंट पे कल इवरा राइट इंस्टॉलमेंट पे करना डिपार्टमेंट टैक्स इवल इवरा मैड लायबिलिटी एक्ने मी अवसाने आगे पोजिशन रिफंड तीन रिफंड के लिए डिपार्टमेंट मैं आट आज नैवत की बीमा करोर तर मे देवनी अवस्था रिफंड ओन टैक्स पे टैक्स पुलव या गिवाण गांटा वेडियन टैक्स के लिए अनिवार्य रिफंड राइट हब मे पॉइंट के रिफंड बे हेम टैक्स पे निकट राइट ए आट मे आउटपुट सप्लाय के अतुले जीरो रेटेड एस वैट तीन विधराय मिथन दिट रिफंड वार तीरना ये रिफंड हेदाई आइटम नंबर वन की आट क्लेम करना राइट आइटम नंबर वन क्लेम करा कि तेम या मेन मे लिमिटेशन एडवे पद लिमिटेशन 100% ऑफ द आउटपुट टैक्स राइट ए लिमिटेशन यटत्वेन नाम या क्लेम कर पुलवांगान यागे आउटपुट टैक्स वेडी वेनवा अन्नी अवस्था या रिफंड क्रिएट वेनो राइट तर एम तमाय ए गन्ने किरीम प्रधान वशेन अदाल वेन राइट तर मेतन दी पोडी रिया का मदक करबो तेंग 227 नेक गुडा कायट मतका अमतकाती राइट 227 की मुकदमी या मतने अड़ते प्रोजेक्ट पड़ा कंस्ट्रक्शन करना यह कल सीमा सप्लाई कटने भाई कंस्ट्रक्शन गन्न पर्चेस यार डिडक्ट रहा विनवा इनपुट तीन पुलवा एक तैपोप समय कॉस्ट कैश फ्लो प्रमाण नोवेन पुलवा बिजनेस कंस्ट्रक्ट कर बिजनेस ओपन करा राइट ऑपरेशन करा एनीस गवर्नमेंट ना पॉलिसी मेक दीपू अवस्थावत्तम राइट 227 अप्रूव रजिस्टर वे पुलवा रजिस्टर वेला अप्रूवल या कर आट सप्लाई का नैतूना इनपुटे क्लेम करना अवस्थाव दिलती राइट आप इधर हंधुना के नियम कर आप तीर पार्टे कथा करा विथ दैट कंसर्न एक्चुअली वी कैन कंक्लूड टुडे सेशन राइट फ्यू क्वेश्चंस वी डिस्कस अबाउट द वेट कैलकुलेशंस Or next session we discuss the another few questions that is related with the VAT. Right thereafter we discuss other questions and other revisions program which is related with the other part. Right with that concern we can meet again. Right then we conclude and have a nice day. Thank you.